practically approved. But for me, just making sure I walk in initially, the rest get on, is probably the biggest thing that I can do.
Yeah, I'll talk to next, I think, definitely just another way, another way I can think of having a conversation would make sense. Glad to do this for us. I think, practice on kids before I leave here.
Yeah, awesome.
I mean, I got plenty of conversation with those who are in progress, so.
That's great.
I'll do that before I go to the dealer, but definitely need some good practice.
Yeah, I would say kind of the same, it's great that, this will teach us to pace and take more time to actually put that. And also repeating ourselves, it gets in us, like it's like driving you down towards yourself. So it'll be a good reminder of your conversation, because sometimes it's one thing that you listen, and other things that you repeat yourself. That is pacing more.
Yes.
Yeah.
It forces us to slow down, because I can get into a rush.
Yeah.
So I feel like that, the routine of it is good. I thought it was nice having everyone here to participate as a team. And that was enjoyable. That's fair when you're in this team, so. Thank you very much for taking the time. I also like, bringing the brain science in.
Thank you, Ian. Thank you for the class. It was very interesting. It was the same. I think a lot of things you just go, you're just such a routine, and we just go with the day, whatever conversations you have. If we remember them, we do. If we don't, just kind of hope we remember what we're supposed to do. I think more so for me, I would use it more personally first, because I have a teenager just facing the same, it's kind of hard having conversations with them these days, because you have to put it in a way that she understands it in her lingo. So making sure I speak her in her language, because it's difficult when you're trying to have like mature conversations sometimes with them. So putting it in her lingo, using your stance, I think probably be good for me, so I can repeat back to her the way she said it, so I can understand. So now I'm going to learn how to speak to her in her language.
I love that. Man, I needed this last night.
I was supposed to help the kid with the project, and I let him read his little project to me, and I was not listening. And I was like, this is good. So then mom goes and looks at it, and she gets upset at me. She was like, did she even look at this? I was like, yes. And she was like, I said, I had him read it to me. And she was like, were you listening to him? And I was like, no. And she was, and so then she started reading to me what it said, and I was like, oh, and she was like, you're not listening. So then I really listened, and I was like, wow, that makes no sense. So I'm so glad you're looking at this project. And it just, it reminded me, like, I need to stop and listen and really pay attention to what they're really talking about, and not just the first 10 seconds, just like, you know, just like what you did interrupted or whatever. So,
all right, well, I need this every day, but I will use this as practice with my performance managers, because for some reason, the dealers call me and they get me all worked up, and I'm calling Maria and everything else. I'm like, what's going on? But I need to slow down and the full picture. So, yep, but I'm slowing down today.
One day at a time.
I'm a work in progress.
1 hour.
Yeah. So, thank you.
I mean, obviously, the listening part, but when you listen to understand with the person, then they put their guard down and you both communicate. I think that's just critical, because we've got our guards up with the dealers, with relationships. All these guards are going up, and it's just like, you're frustrated, so just really trying to take me breathing with the dealer that's frustrated and just listening and repeating back to them and putting them back in that right brain hemisphere, brain, I don't know what you call it, brain hemisphere. I think that's critical. So that's, I mean, kind of, we all know that to listen, but to like really see it in this, really, it's like, it's a critical step, it seems like. It's like really important. Otherwise, you're not gonna reach resolution, basically. And then childhood repeats, because we're trying to heal. That's a big statement. And really think about that. A lot of stuff repeats.